Chabab gum fuck election yai. Ya tomare collector kun mana as pialamba win as pialamba fall. Ya tomare collector kun mana banak gum fuck election yai. Ya tomare collector kun mana as pialamba win as pialamba fall. Ya tomare collector give mana nuhan gum fuck election yai. Ya tomare collector kun mana as pialam the wind, as pialam the fast. Ya komare collector give mana rujal gum fuck election jai. Ya komare collector kun mana as pialam the wind, as pialam the fast. Ya komare collector kun mana wana wala wana wala apo wani ga wante zirai maliyat siapa kemar malay alkon ya. Aqua mandinga bukwale kongo wale bawa jiso dania bagwanya kwar nigo mi lumuri kan kwar mi cher kemal sudat salpakir bayo bagwai balan nyam bagur ke dia kamya ramlan nigo tuwida gwai chanen tejinu bicham am chera gwa balo balan nyam nadia. Gawon melat the tofeng, mencer kawaiwe, incaji diri mengfarwe. Wana wala, apa wan megar, wan terlerai, maliyat, siapa kemal, malay, alkon ya. Apa wan megar, bukwale kongo wala, bawa jiso dan ya. Bagwanya kwar megwa, melomri kan kwar, mencer kemal sudat. Tabandengai bayop bagwai balan nyam bagor ke dia kamya ramlan negai tuira bai chanen jibe tu chen kam chara ga balot balan nyam nadia gawon melai ke topai gawon melai ke topai micher ke bai wi in chaji de farwe.
Invited to stay behind to listen to the presentation by our vice chairman of the SPLM. Those of you who may have other engagements or you are busy, you have to go somewhere, we will be happy to thank you and to wish you a safe journey back home. So to conclude this formal part of our function, I'm going to ask the DJ to play our national anthem. So let us all stand up to conclude this part, and then those who are willing to go can go with the grace of God. DJ. To Comrade Lado Gubek, Lado Jadakube, who is the chair of the SPLM National Secretariat in USA. Comrade Lado.
SPLM OYE! Representing the government of the Republic of South Sudan to Washington and Ottawa, Ambassador Bach, Ambassador Andruga, Comrade Akol Lual Rich, Presidential Envoy for Peace, my colleagues in the National Secretariat, the Women League, the Youth League, the SPLA veterans in diaspora, heads of states of the SPLM chapters, SPLM regional coordinators, community leaders, my comrades, and my fellow South Sudanese citizens. I greet you in the name of your Freedom Party. Yes! The Sudan People's Liberation Movement, and in the name of the Republic of South Sudan, of freedom and democracy, of justice and equality, and of peace and prosperity. I salute you, the women of South Sudan, for your tremendous sacrifices throughout the liberation struggle that set us free from the bondage of Islamic Arab Sudan. I salute you, the youth, for the future of our party, the SPLM, and the future of the Republic of South Sudan lies in the hands of your generation. My fellow comrades, I am here to declare to you that despite the infighting, the debate, the dialogue, and the power struggle within our party, that the spirit of the SPLM remains strong.
Yes!
The SPLM as a political party remains strong, especially in the hands of our generation, you and I of the third generation of the movement. We will carry on the torch of freedom to our children, the fourth generation of the SPLM, with the determination that the SPLM as our Freedom Party will win the next elections and rule South Sudan for decades to come. Victory to you, SPLM. And with that, my fellow comrades, I want to share with you today why I am, as Lado Jadakube, a member of the SPLM. I am a member of the SPLM because I believe in the SPLM vision for free, democratic, just, peaceful, and prosperous South Sudan that belongs to all its citizens, irrespective of pride, irrespective of gender, physical disability, age, religious affiliation, educational background, or economic status. A Republic of South Sudan in which all its citizens live together in harmony with equal opportunities. A Republic of South Sudan where South Sudanism is what binds us together and is the basis of unity and national identity. I am a member of the SPLM because I believe in the SPLM vision of taking towns to the villages, as demonstrated by Ambassador Andruga, who turned the Kerepi from village to town, and by our own Vice President, who turned Lobona from a village to a strategic town in South Sudan. And as clearly demonstrated by a president who yesterday created 28 states so we can take towns in the village. I am a member of the SPLM because I believe in the SPLM vision of empowering women, advancing women's rights as human rights, with the hope and belief that someday a great South Sudanese woman will rise to the presidential palace in Juba as president of the Republic of South Sudan. I believe in the SPLM vision, and that's why I'm a member of the SPLM, because of its vision. Empowering the youth through equal education for all, regardless of gender, by leadership training and mentorship, and by placing the youth in strategic positions with the hope and with the belief that they are the next generation and the next leaders of South Sudan. I am a member of the SPLM because of the SPLM vision of hope, that regardless of where you come from, regardless of what the tribe you belong to and the language you speak in the region you come from, that you can have an opportunity to lead this party. Yes. I am a member of the SPLM Comrades because I believe in the SPLM vision of empowering persons with disability with their own rights, that they too should equally participate in their own country of the Republic of South Sudan. And this is why I am the chairman of the SPLM party in the United States of America today. But not least, my fellow comrades, I am a member of the SPLM because it has achieved my total freedom. A total freedom in the independence of the Republic of South Sudan from the old Sudan, breaking the yoke of oppression that existed in Sudanese society since 1956. These are the reasons why I am a member of the SPLM. And these are the reasons, I hope, why you too are members of the SPLM, or should be members of the SPLM. So with those few words, that the SPLM party is your freedom party. Take it in your heart and take it in your mind. Take it to your children. Take it to your neighbors. Take it to your village. Take it to your towns and your cities. And take it across the Republic of South Sudan. So we will together rise up and win with a very big margin of 99 or 100% in 3 years to come.
Right. Yeah.
Tonight we are honored to have among us one of the veterans, a veteran of the SPLA, a man who, from the founding of the People's Party, the People's Movement, the Sudan People's Liberation Movement, that brought together complex diversities of Sudanese society, from Nimule to Halfa and from Jezira to Kassala, to realize their common destiny as one people in one nation, with one vision and with one journey to the new Sudan. From the beginning, participated with his colleagues, most of whom are no longer alive today, like Abino Kwanyinbol, like William Yon Bany, like Joseph Oduho, Yusuf Kua Meki, Francis Gore, and many others. And today, is closely working with our visionary leader, the man of peace, the man who has united our country and continue to unite our country, His Excellency Salva Kiir Mayardit. We have stood behind him and continue to stand behind him, that we too should stand behind our president. Among us is the man who has given up his position in 2002 for the sake of peace and unity, and the man who is about to also give up his position for the sake of peace and unity for the people of the Republic of South Africa. Lady Madame Noura Iga. So my fellow comrades, would you please join me in welcoming to the podium to tell you the SPLM vision of the transformation of our party and the way forward, His Excellency Comrade James Maniga, the Vice President of the Republic of South Sudan and Deputy Chairman of the Sudan People's Liberation Movement. Let's feel a moye! Let's feel a moye! Let's feel a moye! Kinda moye! Kinda moye! Kinda moye!
Espelle moye. Peace oye. South Sudan oye. Chairman of the SPLM chapter in the United States, our two ambassadors, Nasco Bakuma, Comrade Accord, Lual, and all the senior people here, ladies and gentlemen, good evening to all of you. Salaam alaikum. Yes, le nascullo le junubi kullo modni kullo ba dak ikunde na petana ta korankre de yawo kita korankre be de ga haja petana khas petabe asara petana asan kamane na ka hizib namulu istrategia petana kama kelizi tani na ko hena kelima Sanjaya Singh Vidana called the Bidho, Obe Sabak, Nabe Bisabik Nahana. I Lekin Pitai de Kun Mohadara. Mohadara and Rada Tekanika. So Zoli Kun Jahis Asan to be able to absorb and to analyze this highly technical lexa. So it is a lexa. Al mudo kun ikun kritik belingiz. Le anno ni namasin le tahawur. We are now entering a state of transformation of the SPLM. You see, from time to time, every 2 years, 3 years, every party must devise new approaches so that it does not stagnate. And so SPLM, like any other party, we must continue to plan and plan, reform and reform. This is to chase and to run after modernization, because every political party must modernize. So it is only those who will listen properly, because this is highly technical, that will benefit. You have to know that we are a political party as SPLM. And every political party, the aim and the motive of every political party is to capture power democratically. Is to capture power. But you cannot capture power, my friend, until you follow certain scientific principles of how you reorganize yourself, of how you restructure yourself, and then how you can prepare for the coming elections. So elections will come after 2.5 years. You may see this as a long period, but no, it is at the doorstep. Elections is coming. The best you do is to prepare, because a philosopher called Plato, he said, if it is going to take you one full day to cut down a tree, one full day, you begin to sharpen your axe for half a day. You can see. So that by the time you begin to cut the tree, the axe is sharpened up to throw down the tree in a very short time. So you have to sharpen your axe for half the day. Meaning, you must prepare well for everything. So we have to prepare well, begin from now. And so soon on the ground, we are going to have congresses. And these congresses will lead to convention. And so you in the diaspora, in the chapters, you will also have your own congresses. And then will be required, say from USA, so many come to the convention in Cuba. So you have also got to come out, prove yourself that you can represent these people in the USA, in Cuba. And democratically they will send you to Cuba. From there you can climb all the way also to the National Liberation Council, the NLC, you can climb to the Political Bureau, and then you can climb all the way to the Secretariat and so on of the SPLM, so that you expose yourself. So this is, so for you to be able to contribute effectively, my friend, in the SPLM, let us follow this lecture. It is highly technical, but we can all catch up. Okay, can we go now? Where are you? Huh? When you come to die? So when I say, can we go, it means move to the next page. Who can guess? Where is David? Where is David? Huh?
Is that the beginning? Take me to the beginning. Slowly. Okay. Now come back to this topic. This is the beginning. Can you move slowly up to... You are even too far to see what I want. But that is the wrong position. Okay, so comrades, tonight, this evening, this is our lecture about the SPL. To put you on your toes to prepare for the reorganization of the SPL, transformation of the SPL. So we are talking transforming and consolidating a political party, any political party for that matter, any. So hatta lufizol even min ya hazab tanin sare gunim su jua ina lisa mata la bara males. Kedua sare gunin ang beruang mulu pemidan. But if this man would not swear SPL. And so, Comrade Lado, you are Secretary General or Secretary for Information should begin to circulate papers for attendance. Let us begin to know ourselves. I told you before, register the SPL members. So please register yourself. You are in which state. If you have any qualification, you write it there. And then your telephone numbers. These are important for future contacts. So please begin to circulate this. These are very important. All right. So now, for us to be able to transform the SPLM, we have to compare ourselves, my friend, to other political parties in the world. But let us begin with Africa. Good. So here, emergence of African political parties, how did they begin? The African political parties system traced to their colonial origins and how these parties have responded to the current wave of democratization. Because the whole goal is democracy. The rise of parties is bound up with the rise of parliamentary groups and electoral committees. Is as a result for demand for parliament and their committees. Africans effectively participated in the Second World War. And so for themselves, the need for independence and democratic exercise. Yani but har alamia tani, Afarika fad wa harabu pi Europa, u pi Asia u pi UN, fi nihaya ruwa fad safu biladel munazamin bitirika tal ahzab. Asan yamsik sulta bitirika tal ahzab in kratia. Mungkin kan dia deh, ni narajain Afrika, oh badan ni asal tu macam khawajat mustaqbirin deh kelihat lah. Asal sendiri beres sumpah dah puak kita. Sumpah ke? So mana sih mana sum? Badan pun rakyat tu lop endo Allah mustaqbirin or the colonizers and so must now go let them be left independent. Independence dia wara Second World War in Africa. This is how it began. Sumpah ke? So now, the post-Second World War colonial state could best be described as a reformed state that sought to include Africans in the administration of colonies. Knowing that African agitation for independence was inevitable, this contention was developed into an opportunity to introduce Africans to Western political institutions, including allowing Africans under strict political surveillance to establish political parties to oversee development of the countries. Can we go up, my friend? Continue up until I tell you stop, but slowly. Ayo, la pull stop. Now, there is this writer known as Ali Muzuri. He's a very good writer. He wrote a number of books. This is one of the books he wrote here with his friend called Tide. So Ali Muzuri and Tide in 1984 observed that in the urge to leave behind political institutions similar to their own, the departing colonial parties decided to export to Africa their peculiar version of parliamentary government with several parties and recognized oppositions. Yani na se Faransa indom system piton pita forming political parties. The British have their own system of forming political parties. Al-Almanin, they have the Germans, they have their own system of forming political parties. And so on and so forth. So this is what this party actually means. So in some countries, it took a political elite less than a decade to go from establishing political parties to contesting elections. And you cannot go to elections if you do not prepare yourself properly as a party. Contesting elections and assuming the role of governing their country. Okay, can we go up, my friend? Go on, go on. Aha. Good. Now, we are still in Africa. Taban, for us to be able to proceed as SPLM, then we want to see but the African countries, how did the rest of the countries in Africa organize their parties? And then you will know where to fit in. If you don't know, if you don't compare, my friend, if you don't compare, even in your own house, and you don't compare the food your wife cooks, you may jump to the conclusion that your wife is the best cook. When she may be the last in the village. So you must compare, my friend. Yes. And therefore, we as SPLM, we want to compare to the other African political parties. From there, we will go and compare with the other European political parties. From there, we will come to you and compare how the other political parties in the America are also organized. Then we will know where we fit in our own unique situation. So, okay. All right. So, that's it, my friend. So, we are comparing there. And this is what we have said there. We said in some countries like Sudan, Nigeria, Congo, Angola, Mozambique, Uganda, among others, some nationalism has flared in civil wars. Of liberation, the Pitana Tanya one, or Pitana Zatu SPLM, P. Kenya and Pinas and Mau Mau, or P. Uganda Pinas and so on and so forth. Good. From what some in the marginalized and ethnic minority political elite conceive as a form of internal colonialism exerted by the ruling ethnicity. Now, if initially African political parties emerged to prepare political elite to assume power when their countries were poised to gain independence, some political parties during independence were created by military to bring about development and national integration to what they misconstrued as the trend of division to national integration. Diamond for Africa. They give a reason that there is a threat to nationalhood, or even there is corruption. They always try to justify. So in the beginning, after the Second World War, most of the liberation, there were many military coup d'etats. This is the background for that. Okay. So now, in other instances, civilian politicians who inherited power from the colonialists bent all existing political parties and transformed their state into one-party system in order to achieve goals similar to those pronounced by military leaders. For example, development and national integration. As recent history and subsequent events have shown, both goals remain elusive. Of course, some of the things are not so strongly put together. So they are just put as propaganda. They don't really mean business. Good, can we go up, my friend? Oh,
Okay. Good.
So we say, from the formalist viewpoint, that there is this writer, political writer, Wegener. He wrote his book, 1967, and that is The Faith, from 1 to 2. In that book, he reminds that parties are instruments of collective human actions. You don't work alone in a party, you work as a group here. And creatures of political elite, intellectuals, intelligentsia, you must behave as intellectuals to be able to plan well for your political party. It's not a joke. Either politicians trying to control government or government elites trying to control the message, because you must go to the people. If you don't bring people with you, you are wasting time. In competitive, we call this competitive multipartism. So in multipartism systems, parties are organized by politicians to win elections. Given the kuta to capture power. My power through the ballot box, not the bullets. You see, in authoritarian systems, parties are organized to affect the attitudes and behavior of the population. In both instances, an organization structure must be formed, money must be raised, cadres recruited, officers selected, and procedures for internal organization. Can we go up, my friend? Go on. Yes, okay, good.
Ya samin ta manda ka haje de microphone ana se na ma sa de ta kala na sa du wallahi ana za ta fara na ta shi
dai komando
ya la na ta la ka bana ni
na ya ba na ku ta le na ka mani ta
Ana Baden Maguna dentro de Aro Yato. Lekin Ana Baden Begun SPLM Okoma Bitana, the Kararo Maraten will be repeated 2 times. After that, the Dilibu Okoma Bitana SPLM Maraten Kama. Lakin has the Sapa Peras Toke. SPLM Okoma Bitana. SPLM Okoma Bitana.
Action yai ya tomare collect kun mana as pialan bawin ya tomare collect kun mana banagum pok collection yai ya tomare collect kun mana as pialan bawin ya tomare collect give mana nuwan gum pok collection yai ya tomare Collector Kun Manah.